Joe Paterno is 84 years old in his 46th season. His 409 victories is a record in major college football. News 8 Sports Director Pat Principe is here with more on Paterno's coaching legacy. Certainly so.
It's certainly important to point out here, this decision is a Joe Paterno decision to retire. This is not the school's decision. The Board of Trustees could easily decide, hey, when they meet Friday in a special session, you're out immediately.
You're done now.
So the Joe Paterno era may be over, you know, before Saturday. But with that in mind, we're going to take a look back now on the impact that Joe Paterno has. And he's had a great impact, not only on his football team, but on the entire university.
Joseph Vincent Paterno was born December 21st, 1926, on 18th Street in Brooklyn. A starter at Brooklyn Prep High School and then at quarterback for Brown University under Rip Engel. After graduation, Paterno intended to follow in the footsteps of his father and become a lawyer until Engel took the head coaching job at Penn State in 1950 and asked Joe to become his assistant. 16 years later, Joe Paterno succeeded Engel as the Nittany Lions head coach. In his four-plus decades as the Lion King, Paterno's teams completed 5 undefeated seasons, winning national championships at the 1983 Sugar Bowl and the 1987 Fiesta Bowl. He is number one all-time in bowl game coaching victories. One of his most memorable regular season wins came on October 27, 2001, when Penn State came from 18 points down to defeat Ohio State and moved Paterno past Bear Bryant as the winningest coach in Division I college football history.
It's hard to measure something that happened 10 years ago, 5 years ago, with today. I certainly wouldn't be anything that's topped this. It wouldn't. This would have to be right there with everything that's happened to me.
Joe Paterno was way more than just a football coach. His so-called grand experiment put equal emphasis on accomplishments on the field and in the classroom and has produced more than 24 first-team academic All-Americans, 14 Hall of Fame scholar athletes, and a graduation rate of better than 70%. He and his wife, Sue, have donated millions of dollars to Penn State towards scholarships and building projects. In 2007, Paterno was inducted into the College Football Hall of Fame. But maybe his most treasured honor was in June of 2001, when Joe Pa became one of the few sports figures to receive the Pennsylvania Founders Award.
And I said, Pop, I don't want to be alive. I want to be a coach. He put his arm around me and he said, Joe, he said, I've given all of my life to give you the best opportunity to be something special. He said, I want you to be something special. He said, you've got leadership qualities. There's things about you that people gravitate to you. If you're going to coach, he said, whatever you do, he said, make sure you make an impact on people and an institution. I feel like I made an impact. Thank you.
And turn back the clock just a few weeks ago, Penn State beating Illinois when the Illini missed this field goal. That made Joe Paterno the all-time winningest coach in major college football history. It was his 409th career victory. Just some of the accomplishments in the life and career of Joe Paterno at Penn State. 409 career wins. That's the most in major college football history, and his 24 postseason wins, bowl game wins, that is also a record. And, of course, Penn State will play in a bowl game this year. The bigger question is, will Joe Paterno be coaching in that bowl game? If he goes out on his terms, which I think he is trying to do by making this statement today, he will be. But, again, as we said before, that's
right.
still up to the Board of Trustees.
Up in the air. And,
right.
Of course, lots of speculation on who will step in as the next head coach.
That's a whole new beehive there. And, of course, you know, the biggest name being thrown around out there is former Florida head coach Urban Meyer, who we've reported earlier in the week was spotted on campus again, has bought property in the area, reports that his daughter, who is an outstanding volleyball player, may be enrolling at Penn State. So he is definitely at the top of the list. There's a lot of other names out there. You can be sure it's not going to be somebody on Joe Paterno's staff. They're going to make a clean sweep of everything there and bring a new coach and a whole new staff in there. But Urban Meyer right now, obviously number one with a bullet.
All right. Well, thanks, Pat. Thanks for all of that. Mm-hmm. Appreciate it.